subscribe to LearnCab and hit the bell icon to get notified.
Blocked input tax credits. Friends, on certain inward supplies, the government doesn't want to allow input tax credit. You might have received the goods, you might have received the services, you might have received the invoices, you might have satisfied all the conditions. The government is least interested. It tells you, boss, for these inward supplies, I'm not going to allow you these credits. These are blocked. We do not even want to check whether you have satisfied the conditions or not. These are outright blocked credits. Now, the reasons could be many. Few of the reasons why the government wants to block this credit is to avoid disputes. Now, what do you mean by avoid disputes? Friends, there are certain inward supplies wherein it is very difficult to establish whether these inward supplies have been actually used in the course of furtherance of business or not. Say, for example, a sole proprietary concern. The proprietor purchases a car and the car is invoiced in the name of the proprietary concern and the GST number of the proprietary concern is mentioned. The car is received, the invoice is received. Now, the proprietor wants to take the credit. Friends, now, is it possible to establish that whether the proprietor has used the car only in the course of furtherance of business? There could be a case where the proprietor has got the billing alone in the name of the proprietary concern, but the car is actually used by his son for personal uses. So therefore, the government is not very sure and it doesn't have any means to check whether in reality this good, this inward supply has been used in the course of furtherance of business or not. So the government doesn't want to enter into any disputes. It just tells, leave us, we are not going to give you credit on this. The second could be increase in revenue. Now friends, for construction of an immovable property, for example, I'm saying you, for construction of an immovable property, credits are denied. Now, this could be a case where it is clear cut it is used in the course of furtherance of business. Say, for example, you get a factory constructed. Now, obviously, this factory is going to be used in the course of furtherance of business, but still, the credit is not allowed for construction of this immovable property. It is blocked. You would have satisfied all the conditions, but still, this credit is blocked because the government wants to increase its revenue collection. Now, there is huge credits which are lying in immovable properties. If the government is giving credits on these immovable properties, ultimately, the revenue collection of the government is going to lower. Because the moment input tax credit is taken, so much amount of output tax is not going to be paid. This is going to be adjusted against the output tax liability, which is actually decreasing the revenue collection of the government. Friends, please understand, whenever an output tax is paid by the supplier, if input tax credit is actually booked by the recipient, that is not the revenue of the government. It is only one debit and one credit. Only when the ultimate consumer, whatever he is paying, that goes to the pocket of government, or when the credit is blocked, that goes to the pocket of government. So to avoid disputes, the government can block ITC. To increase its revenue, the government can block ITC. And friends, whatever may be the reason, blocking input tax credit is against the principle. It is against the principle of indirect taxes. It is against the principle of GST, because the moment credit is blocked, it results into cascading effect of taxes. Because when you are going to block the credit, that credit will form a part of the cost and it is going to result into cascading effect of taxes. Having understood this, now let us see the credits which are blocked. We go to section 17, subsection 5, which gives a list of blocked credits. So first is in relation to motor vehicles. Let us have a look. 17, subsection 5, notwithstanding anything contained in subsection 1 of section 16 and subsection 1 of section 18. The government is telling you whether you have satisfied the conditions, whether you have received the goods, received the invoices, satisfied all the other conditions, I am least bothered. Overrate everything, forget everything. Input tax credit shall not be available in respect of the following. So for the following items, I am not going to give you input tax credit. A. Motor vehicles for transportation of persons having approved seating capacity of not more than 13 persons, including the driver, except when they are used for making the following taxable supplies, namely. So friends, so far what we have seen, any motor vehicle which is having an approved seating capacity, any motor vehicle which is having an approved seating capacity up to 13, including the driver. It is telling you of not more than 13, including the driver. So it is up to 13 including the driver. So any motor vehicle which is for transportation of persons having an approved seating capacity of not more than 13 including the driver, which means up to 13 including the driver, credit is not going to be allowed, excepting when they are used for making the following taxable supplies. So the general principle is motor vehicle having an approved seating capacity up to 13 including the driver, I will not give you credit. However, I will give you the credit even for these vehicles. Which vehicles? Motor vehicle having an approved seating capacity up to 13 including the driver, I will give you credit for these vehicles when they are used for making following taxable supplies, namely further supply of such motor vehicles. That means there's a person who's purchased, let's suppose there's a car dealer, the car dealer is purchasing a car, that car, let's suppose it is 8-seater car, generally it is disallowed because up to 13 credit is not going to be allowed. Now there's a car dealer who's purchasing an 8-seater car and further supplying this 8-seater car, should he be allowed the credit? The answer is yes. So it is telling you, even though it is an 8-seater car which is generally not allowed, but still I will allow you because it is being used for further supply of such motor vehicles. Now friends, the same example. Now there's a person who is giving car on rental basis. There's a person who is giving the cars on rental basis. Now there's a person who is having, let's suppose, some 108-seater cars. He gives this cars on a rental basis. The rental happens to be somewhere around 2000 per day. Friends, this is not transportation passenger services, please understand. Let's suppose I'm having motor cars, I have 100 motor cars or all 8 seaters or less than 8 seaters. I'm not doing transportation passenger services. You're asking me to drop over there, I'm not going to do that. My business is only to give this car on rentals. Wherever you want, you take and go. The rental per day is going to be 2000 rupees. Now, this is renting of motor vehicles. This is not transportation passenger services. It is renting of motor vehicles. Now, this person, he has purchased 100 cars, 8-seaters. Is credit allowed? Generally, no, because it tells you up to 13 including the driver, I will not allow you the credit. So this is 8-seater. It is up to 13. Credit is generally not allowed. Is it covered under the exception? It tells you, if this car is used for further supply of such motor vehicles, is this car being used for further supply? Friends, please understand over here, further supply doesn't necessarily mean you should sell it. It didn't tell you further supply of goods. No, it does not mean that you purchase these cars and only when you are going to sell this. It is not sale. It is not further sale of such motor vehicles. It is further supply of such motor vehicles, and supply could be supply of goods or supply of services. Now this motor car is being used for further supply of such motor vehicle, that is, it is for further supply means what? It is for giving on rent. Credit can be taken. So friends, it is further supply of such motor vehicle. Supply doesn't necessarily mean sale. Supply includes sale as well as services. So supply includes supply of goods as well as supply of services. Transportation of passenger services. Now let's suppose there's KSRTC. Now this KSRTC is purchasing a car which is 8-seater. So if it is purchasing a bus which happens to be 14-seaters or 21-seaters, we are not going to discuss this because in general principle itself it is going to be allowed. What is disallowed? The general principle up to 13, having an approved seating capacity up to 13 is disallowed. KSRTC purchases a car 8-seater capacity and now it is engaged in transportation of passenger services. It is not giving on rent. It is transportation of passenger services. Coimbatore to Bangalore rental is 1000 rupees. Coimbatore to Bangalore ticket cost is 1000 rupees. It is not rental services. It is transportation of passenger services. Can credit be taken? Credit can be taken because this is covered in the exception. Next, imparting training on driving such motor vehicles. Let's suppose there's Maruti driving school. It is purchasing cars, 8-seater cars. Generally credit not allowed. But since this Maruti driving school is going to use this for imparting training or driving such motor vehicles, credit can be allowed. Friends, this is all with motor vehicles. I tell the principle again. The general principle tells you, as regards this motor vehicle is concerned, up to 13 including the driver, credit will not be allowed. Which motor vehicles? Those motor vehicles which are having an approved seating capacity up to 13 including the driver. That means those motor vehicles which are for the purpose of transportation of persons, credit will not be allowed. Exception tells you it will be allowed when it is for used for further supply of such motor vehicles. This supply could be supply of goods and supply of services, transportation of passengers, imparting training or driving motor vehicles, credit will be allowed. Now let me give you cases. Let's suppose there's a company. This company purchases a car, 8-seater capacity. It is going to be used exclusively for business purposes. It is for local travel of MD. It is for local travel of managing director. Is credit going to be allowed? The answer is no, because it is not used for any of these purposes. It is going to be used for local travel of the MD. But is it for further supply of such motor vehicles? The answer is no. Is it transportation of passenger? Is MD a passenger? The answer is no. Is it for imparting training or driving motorcycles? The answer is no. So therefore, credit is not going to be allowed. Case number 2. A 14-seater bus is purchased by a company for pickup and drop of its employees. Will credit be allowed? Now friends, where is credit denied? Credit is denied only when if it is a motor vehicle having an approved seating capacity up to 13 including the driver. Now since it is 14, credit is going to be allowed. It is not disallowed at all. Point number 3. Let's suppose there's a factory who's purchasing a Tempo or a pickup vehicle or an auto rickshaw. Not auto rickshaw or an auto, which is used essentially, which is used for transportation of goods. So there's a factory which is purchasing a Tempo for taking the raw materials from godown to the factory. Can credit be taken on this motor vehicle? The answer is yes. Because friends, what is blocked? Please understand the general principle. The general principle, what is blocked is motor vehicles which is for transportation of persons and having an approved seating capacity up to 13 including the driver. Only that is blocked, and an exception which is given, it is only for this general rule. The general rule tells you motor vehicle for transportation of persons having an approved capacity up to 13, credit is disallowed. The exceptions are to this disallowance. A motor vehicle which is used for transportation of goods, credit is allowed. There is no disallowance on such motor vehicles. Let's suppose there's a bank who's purchasing a cash carrying van. There's a bank which purchases a cash carrying van for transfer of cash, for transporting cash from the branch till the currency chest. So this cash carrying van is being purchased by the bank. Can credit be taken of this cash carrying van? It is a specifically defined, designed for carrying cash. Now friends, if you tell me that motor vehicle for transportation of goods is allowed, so therefore this should be allowed, your answer will be technically wrong. Please understand and concentrate. This is important interpretation. If you are telling me, or if you are writing in examination, motor vehicles for transportation of goods is allowed, so therefore this also should be allowed, you will become technically wrong, because friends, it is a cash carrying van. What is cash? It is money. Is money goods? The answer is no. Money is not goods, because the definition of goods excludes money and securities. So money is not goods, and what is being carried is not goods. Is money services? Can you tell I am carrying services? Answer is no, because money is not services as well. So now this cash carrying van is neither transporting goods nor it is transporting services. So if you are writing in examination, cash carrying van, it is used for transportation of goods, therefore credit should be allowed. Credit should be allowed, that is correct, but your reasoning is not correct. So what reasoning you have to mention? You have to mention what is disallowed. Disallowance is for motor vehicle for transportation of persons having an approved seating capacity up to 13 including the driver is disallowed. This is not forming a part of disallowance, so therefore credit is going to be allowed. Friends, credit is allowed, but you shouldn't write the reason that it is allowed because it is used for transportation of goods. No. Motor vehicle, credit is disallowed only in this case. Since this is not fitting into this case, credit is allowed. I'm sure you're able to follow this. So now friends, this is the summary of what we have discussed. motor vehicles for transportation of persons having an approved seating capacity greater than 13. So it is greater than 13 means 14 and above, credit is allowed. Next, motor vehicle for transportation of persons having an approved seating capacity up to 13, including the driver. When they are used for, if they are used for these three reasons, further taxable supply of such motor vehicle, transportation of passengers, imparting training on driving such motor vehicle, credit is going to be allowed. This supply includes supply of goods as well as supply services. You can sell this or you can also rent them. Any other purpose, motor vehicle for transportation of persons having an approved seating capacity up to 13, if it is used for any other purpose, then credit is not going to be allowed. Example, a car being used for MD. All other motor vehicle, credit is allowed, because what was disallowed was only motor vehicle which is for transportation of persons having an approved seating capacity up to 13. All other motor vehicle, for example, motor vehicle used for transportation of goods, cash carrying vans, special purpose motor vehicle such as forklifts, etc., for them credit is going to be allowed. So friends, this is very important. Again, special purpose motor vehicles, forklifts, etc., for them credit is going to be disallowed. In general, friends, you need to remember only one principle. I know I'm repeating, but it should sink in your mind. The credit where it is not allowed is motor vehicle for transportation of persons having an approved seating capacity up to 13, credit is disallowed. If you're covered by those three exceptions, credit is allowed. For all other motor vehicles, credit is allowed.
Subscribe to LearnCab and hit the bell icon to get notified.